On Tech Tree this week, we bring you an exclusive hands-on review of the iPad 2. As the tablet wars begin, we tell you who wins the first battle between the iPad 2 and the Motorola Zoom. That's not all. 2011 is going to witness a surge of new tablets. We get you the best of the lot.
Welcome to a brand new edition of Tech Tree. This episode is all about the iPad 2 and we promise you it's going to be an exciting one. We've got it with us, but before we reveal it to you, let's take a look at how the iPad has become such a huge game changer.
It's been a little over a year since the first iPad was out, and ever since, this simple yet revolutionary tablet has become an integral part in the lives of millions. Be it at work, play, navigation, music, food, art, or even helping children with autism learn better. This so-called post-PC device has seeped into every sphere imaginable, and its versatility is limited only by the end user. Its easy-to-use touch interface makes it appealing to everybody, no matter how old or young you may be. Not limited to being just a personal device, the iPad has also opened doors for tablets to be used innovatively in areas like healthcare and education. And now the iPad 2 seems poised to carry forward this legacy. It has reportedly sold close to 1 million units in the first weekend itself and is currently sold out in all stores in the United States.
Well, the demand for the iPad 2 is so high that at the flagship Apple store in New York, a woman actually sold her first spot in the queue for $900. How cool is that? So while hundreds queue up to buy the iPad 2, we have it with us exclusively on Tech Tree. Let's not waste any more time and bring in Anant here. He's the guy who's got the iPad 2 with him right now. So Anant, what really is your first impression?
Yes, Radhika, that's right. I have it right here with me. It's funny how a year ago, Apple didn't know what to expect from this device. People were calling it a larger version of the iPhone. And now, 11 months and 15 million iPads later, it's time for the second generation, the iPad 2. The first thing that you notice about the iPad 2 is that this time around it comes with a smart cover. Not only does this protect your screen, but this can be folded like this and placed on a table to actually support it when you're typing something. And this can also be flipped like this. And this is the coolest part. You don't actually need a support to put the iPad on. It stands by itself and this is very cool.
The iPad 2 is powered by a dual-core processor, which means faster loading of applications and a much better game performance.
Legion in the air by Ronaldo.
And yes, it also comes with a highly anticipated dual camera, the front one for video calling and the back one to record HD video. And these can be edited on the iPad itself through a new app called iMovie. Plus, for your presentations, you can even connect the iPad 2 to an HD display for full HD visuals.
Okay, so we've seen what the new iPad has to offer in terms of both software and hardware. And if you are wondering what it really feels like to own one, we have someone who can tell you that as well. Here's Anant catching up with Vishal Gondal, who right now is probably one of the first owners of the iPad 2 in the entire country.
Yes, Radhika, that's right. This is the first iPad 2 in India. And more importantly, I've got the man who's got it down right from the States. So Vishal, who did you have to kill for this?
Well, all I can say is that I had to pull in a few favors and I got my hands on this baby at 7 in the evening in New York, so that was fun. I took the first flight out next day and I was probably the first to land in India with an iPad 2.
First impression, I mean, how does it feel?
Much, much sleeker design, I would say much thinner. It's a little more curvaceous, they have added a little more curves. Yeah. Curves to this, it's lighter. And I love the design, I think it's great.
And in comparison to the old iPad, now, oh my God, this just feels like this heavy cloaked device.
So I think they brought a solution. They put this, what they call as the smart cover. It kind of plugs in very, very small. It's quite thin and lightweight. And the beauty is it kind of automatically clips on.
Yeah, so
it has
some
kind of a magnetic thing and you can just...
Yeah, I know, exactly.
Clips on.
And it, I mean, you don't have to align it or anything. It automatically locks at the right spot.
It locks at the right spot and it has a very good proximity sensor. So when you actually close it, it actually shuts the iPad, and when you open it, it opens.
And it's the perfect fit, you know. And you know, as an accessory, I think they've done a great job because you can fold it up, use it when you're typing.
You can do all kinds of cool things with it.
Yeah.
But the beauty is that for the first time, it is complementing the design. It is not making it heavier, bulkier, and not going away from the shape of the design.
And that's exactly, I think, as rightly put, this is exactly what they wanted. They didn't want to cover up such a beautiful device, and they've got it absolutely right. So it is lighter and thinner than the original iPad, and let's not forget, much more powerful. What about the dual core processor?
I think clearly the dual core processor is making a difference. You know, the games are, you know, all the gaming apps are considerably faster. And I think one real way to look at this is using the photo booth app, which is kind of manipulating many, many images at the same time. So it's really beautiful use of the app. And as you can see here.
Yeah. Wow, this is just like the Mac experience. We've got all the effects, the light tunnel, the kaleidoscope, and the thermal camera and everything. It's all happening there.
Apple is redefining what smaller and smarter devices can do.
So it's not only got these apps like Photo Booth, and then there's iMovie. So now you can edit your own videos on the iPad itself. What about the gaming performance?
Gaming performance is significantly better. The games load faster. The graphics is much more richer. And I think this is really opening the way for Unreal Engine and all the high-end 3D console engines, which were wanting to come badly on the iPad. So I think with this hardware, with this graphics, this is going to be a serious competition to a PlayStation 3 or even an Xbox. So this could truly be a console replacement.
So a combination of all these features just puts the old iPad to shame now. You know,
it was just the start, as it said. And you know, it's a good device if you are just doing email, etc. But if you are getting a power user, and of course you want to use the camera is. I would say I'm a little disappointed with the resolution. They could have made it at least 5 megapixels, because you know, when you take pictures you want higher resolution. The camera resolution is low, and I can flip between the back and the front camera and the video and the camera mode. And
it's actually going to be funny seeing people hold up their 10-inch iPads to take photographs.
This is not a device which you would use to take actual professional.
I think it was also kind of forced because they had to match up to the other tablets.
Camera is more meant for video conferencing. I think that's really the core feature of a camera.
So now that you mentioned about the two cameras, let's actually make a FaceTime call and let's see how that works.
Yeah, let me make a call to a friend of mine who's also on the FaceTime. Can I call him? And there you are. Connecting, and there he is. Hello. Hey, you are on Tech Tree.
This is the first FaceTime call from
an iPad 2.
This is awesome.
I'm glad to be here.
Saying something.
We're not used to doing FaceTime chat.
I know, this is new.
This is awesome. I mean, we've been talking about FaceTime for a while, but actually using it on the iPad 2 is phenomenal.
But what people are talking about is augmented reality. So a lot of apps are now going to use this camera to use augmented reality.
Yeah.
And maybe this could be the device which can really, so you could go and put it on a newspaper or on a monument and get. So,
like layer or something.
So augmented reality apps would benefit from this camera.
I mean, this is just the beginning, and we've seen people do crazy things with the iPad. Now with the camera on the iPad, I'm sure they'll come up with their various apps and come up with different uses for the iPad once again.
What you've not even thought about before.
Yeah, exactly. So basically, they've got everything right, and the icing on the cake is the pricing. They've maintained the same price as the original iPad.
It's incredible. Same pricing. I think the users will love it, and people are going to grab it by the millions. I was told that it's already a million of them have already been
exactly.
sold. And believe me, I think this is going to be probably one of the fastest selling Apple devices.
I agree. Over a million devices sold in the first weekend. But I mean, when is this coming to India? It's sad that we don't
I think that, you know, they are just, you know, they're struggling to meet the demand in America. And clearly, I think, you know, India is really not on their priority list.
Yeah, that's right. In fact, Apple lost out last year because the Galaxy Tab and the Dell Streak were launched before the original
Apple
iPad.
Apple and the consumers who bought the Galaxy Tab and the other Android devices.
But there was no choice, right? Apple was very late in the game. I mean, other companies were willing to explore the Indian market. So they brought their tablets.
Just think about it. Apple has come up with iPad 2 and Android has not even come up with their first proper OS for a tablet. So that's the head start they have. They are miles ahead of
Apple. Agreed, they are miles ahead, but there are a lot of non-Apple fans, there are a lot of Android fans for that matter, who are taking to different hardware, different form factors, different reasons.
I think that's going to be a different discussion.
Our point is that Apple should be listening to us right now. They lost out in the first year with the original iPad. Galaxy Tab was here, the Dell Streak was here, the iPad was launched in India only a month and a half ago. And now with the iPad 2 right around the corner, it's available, it's sold out, the buzz is all about the iPad 2. Will we see the iPad 2 a year later? I don't think that makes sense. Apple should bring it much sooner.
Okay, so the good news is that the iPad 2 has been tagged at the same price as the previous edition, starting at $499. This one's quite a steal. But when will it come to India? Well, we don't know that. Why isn't it already here? That too, we don't really know. But what we do know is that this time around, Apple will face some serious competition. Let's take a quick breather right now, but stay tuned to find out why Apple needs to fight hard to survive the tablet wars this year.